I have my dry towel wrapped around, my little bathroom bucket, loofah, toothbrush. I'm ready to go take a shower. I placed my hand on the doorknob when a very important question came to my head. Should I bring my Bluetooth speaker in here? Now you may not be having that internal battle of whether or not you should listen to music as you brush your teeth, poop, wash dishes, or even run to another part of the house. No kidding, I once turned on Spotify to go to the kitchen for a snack. Why do we need to play music when we do stuff? Is it to keep the brain entertained as we do mundane tasks like cutting grass? Or do we just need music blasting in our ear at all times because we're dopamine-sucking vampires that don't know how to handle a bit of silence? I'll never forget, it was the year 2013. An artist I was heavily fond of at the time, Lecrae, dropped Church Clothes 2. I was spinning this mixtape like a propeller, repeat after repeat. Specifically the song, If I Die Tonight. Either my 13-year-old mind was just vibing on the sonic of the sound, or I legit thought I was closer than further from death, hopefully the former. Either way, I loved that song. I went to my cousin's house, and for some reason, we didn't have any internet connection. No Wi-Fi, no minutes, no satellite, no streaming, no online, no gaming, no
nothing.
Never mind the fact that I couldn't play online video games or watch YouTube. I couldn't play the song. The only reason I remember this to this day is because I never felt a legit hunger to listen to music. A hunger, I needed to hear that song again. I remember lying on the floor and feeling deprived. The second I returned home, I played If I Die Tonight 13 times in a row. But that's the crazy thing about music. It has nothing to do with our survivability. If someone walked up to me and reached back as far as the ground and swung up toward my face, my eyes are gonna close because they're defending and protecting themselves. Our body has a bunch of defense mechanisms like that. But I can't tell you why when the beat drops on International Player's Anthem, my body must nod its head. That has nothing to do with my survival. Or so I think. The question is, do we need music to survive? Okay, so this is so fascinating. Bear with me. Emotions drive humans. A lot of actions that humans do are driven by some form of an emotion. All right, let's take a grill. We're at a barbecue now. To cook meat, you need fire. To make a fire, you need fuel. Fuel can be coal, sticks. My rocky relationship crazy people, you can burn your significant other's clothes. Burgers gonna smell like Nike jumpsuits and trucker hats. To act, you need emotion. To drive emotion, you need music. What I'm saying is that music is one of those fuels we can use. Music is coal, baby. Music can cook up emotions. For example, feed the starving African children. I am willing to bet bread that if it wasn't for the music in those commercials, then people would donate a lot less. Don't get me wrong, people would still donate. They'd still be driven by emotion even without music. What I'm depicting is that music has the distinct ability to enhance, drive, or cater to an emotion. When you're sad and you're in your feelings, your fifis, dog, what do? I'll tell you what I'm doing. Putting on some R&B. Nothing fast. I don't want to hear no hippity hop bop skip, none of that. I'm going to cater to my feeling of sadness. I'm going to put on some slow music. Having a soundtrack to your emotions, dog? I'm not going there with y'all. That's a whole nother video. Ever been listening to music and becoming slightly irritated when it's interrupted? Hey, Grandma. Or when the music is interrupted at a party and someone says that the vibe was killed. What I'm telling you is that there is science behind the vibe. Every musical system has a syntax, that is, a set of rules concerning which sounds follow other sounds. We've been learning syntax since we were little itty bitty babies. It's the reason why we know that people who can't sing can't sing. Even those of us that don't know music, we know when someone or an instrument is a little off. I'm no musician, but I know you have a friend that is one. Ask them. They can probably tell you the proper way chords and notes and stuff are supposed to be set up. I'm just gonna demonstrate that through the power of editing. One of the hardest singles to ever drop in the 1800s by one of the world's most massive pop stars, Beethoven. The The ability to anticipate future events based on past experience. One of the most critical aspects of music. This explains why music is so goddamn good. Because it's one of the most simple routes to satisfaction. I expect X, and X happen. Expectations are as important a source of pleasure as resolutions.
Ooh, that's a bar.
It's the buildup of expecting something to happen and then it happening. It just showers us with dopamine. The feel-good hormone, pleasure, baby. This constant loop of expecting a predictable pattern is why crowds are able to sing God's plan when the beat lifts. Our brain loves patterns, predictability, and met expectations. For example, if we go to sleep and wake up at the same exact time for 7 days straight, on the eighth day, we can likely go without an alarm clock because our brain would just wake us up at the same time we've been waking up. It patternized it. If I see a group of black people running, I'm going to assume there is danger in that direction, and I'm running too. Now, if there really was danger and I escaped safely, then I survived based on my prediction. That's prediction. If I drop this pen, I expect gravity to work. That's expectation. Music is one of the only things that has a pattern, is predictable, and meets our expectations. Doing research for this video, I thought that we were a bunch of dopamine fiending zombies that needed a constant tube feeding of pleasure. But the truth is, we might just need music for our survival.